Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. My name is Iqbal Naseem and I'm project manager for the National Zakah Foundation for Mercy Mission in the UK. With me is Sheikh Bilal Ismail. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Bilal.
Wa alaikum assalam, brother Naseem. And how are you?
Alhamdulillah, I'm doing very well. How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah.
Brothers and sisters, with Sheikh Bilal, we're going to be discussing a few issues pertaining to zakah in order that some doubts may be cleared, some misconceptions will be cleared, etc., etc. And we'll be addressing various topics with respect to zakah in order for us to increase our knowledge and understanding of this very important topic in Islam. So first question, Sheikh, for somebody who has no knowledge of zakah, is very new to this topic, perhaps in a few sentences you can just explain what is zakah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Brother Naseem, we find in the Noble Quran many a times, in fact 32 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the matter of zakah. Allah states, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ. Establish the prayer and pay your zakah. And so many a times, directly after Allah talking about salah, He mentions the matter of zakah, showing that they both tie in very, very strongly. And so zakah linguistically means an increase. It means growth. It means barakah, subhanAllah. Many a person feels that once I pay my zakah, I'm going to decrease in my wealth. But rather Allah states, if you pay your zakah, you're going to have an increase. It's purification of your wealth. خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ. That take from them this wealth, so it would purify their wealth. As for the legal sharia definition, then it is haqqun mali, it is a right upon the wealth. Not necessarily a right upon the individual, but rather a right, a haqq upon the wealth and specific types of wealth. So not your house, not the clothing that you're wearing, not the watch that you wear, rather specific types of wealth. لِطَائِفَةٍ مَخْصُوصًا, for a specific group of individuals. We're not allowed to take our zakah and give it to any person walking the street. And lastly, في وَقْتٍ مَعْلُومٍ, at a specific time in the year. And only one time in the year do we pay our zakah. Now.
And we know that obviously zakah is one of the pillars of Islam. Typically we say that it's the third pillar of the pillars of Islam. When did it become an obligation upon the Muslims to pay the zakah?
We find in the days of Makkah al-Mukarramah, when the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there with his companions before the Hijrah, we find that numerous verses and numerous ahadith, he would encourage the Sahaba, he would encourage them to go out and give charity. But it was not an obligation at that time. It was only in the second year after the Hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that this institution of zakah was now made an obligation upon every single Muslim, those who had obviously the ability. Yeah.
And someone might say, for example, that, you know, I give a lot of sadaqah throughout the year. Why do I need to particularly, you know, sort of work out, calculate, go through all the hassle and the difficulty of calculating the zakah? Because, you know, actually, if I add up all my sadaqah over the course of the year, probably will be many, many times over the actual amount that I would end up paying in zakah.
No. I mean, no doubt there's khair and there's barakah in one giving out sadaqah. But one cannot offset this with one zakah. This zakah is a pillar of al-Islam. If you gave sadaqah, walhamdulillah, but as for your zakah, then this is an obligation upon every single Muslim, those who reach and fulfill those certain criteria. We find in the hadith of Jibreel, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, what is Islam? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the shahadatain, he mentioned salah, and then he mentioned the matter of zakah. If an individual denies the obligation of zakah, this person ceases to be a Muslim.
And finally, Sheikh, there's one issue that sometimes people ask about is the fact that also in respect of the topic of zakah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran often uses the word sadaqah, but then we are told actually this means zakah in this particular place.
No.
So maybe you can just explain this and also just quickly differentiate between sadaqah, zakah, and sometimes obviously people talk about things like lillah, etc. So perhaps you can just differentiate between these terms.
We find in the Noble Quran, as mentioned previously, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Tawbah, verse number 60, that إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ لِلْفُقَرَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ, where Allah talked about the 8 categories of individuals who are allowed to take zakah. Allah mentioned the word sadaqah, that the sadaqah is for those individuals. Other verses also, Allah mentioned the matter of sadaqah and says that take from them this sadaqah. In the Noble Quran, we find places where the word zakah is used, and the places where the word sadaqah is used, and they are used for one of the other, used as synonyms. And the zakah means the sadaqah, and sadaqah means the zakah. Yes, when we talk usually today, it means when we speak, we say zakah,
meaning the obligatory charity, and our sadaqah, the non-obligatory, the supererogatory type of charity. So if someone had said that I gave my sadaqah to a certain individual, I mean, this could mean their zakah, it could mean their non-zakah, not a major problem in that. But if we just had to speak on the street, usually zakah is used for the obligatory charity, sadaqah used for non-obligatory, and similar with lillah. Lillah meaning for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word sadaqah comes from the root of sidq. Sidq, which means the person who is truthful, somebody who believes in something, you know, full-heartedly. That this person who gives this charity believes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward him. And similarly, when a person pays the mahr, the sadaq, it's also called the mahr when he gets married, showing his seriousness in the matter, that I'm willing to put down this money down here to his, you know, for his wife, showing his responsibility that he's going to take up all of this financial burden in looking after her. Now, so sadaqah, nafil charity, lillah for the sake of Allah, both mean the same thing, and your zakah, the obligation.
Jazakallah khair.